चाहे तुमको दिल से गाए ये गीत मिलके, तेरे नाम यीशु नाम की जय। Welcome back to the other 167. I'm Vandana and I bring you greetings in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, our true living God. So friends, I hope you all are fine and praying. Today we have with us Pastor Biju Thampi and he is going to explain to us in his beautiful encouraging words that we can be inspiration for others. We have to be inspiration for others. We have to encourage others like Jesus did. So let's welcome Biju Thampi.
Hello, my name is Biju Thampi and I want to welcome you to another episode of The Other 167. Today I want to talk to you from a passage from the Bible which is probably very familiar for all of you. It's from the Gospel of Mark chapter 6. We will read from verse 30. Then the apostles gathered to Jesus and told him all things, both what they had done and what they had taught. And he said to them, come aside by yourself to a deserted place and rest a while. For there were many coming and going and they did not even have time to eat. So they departed to a deserted place in the boat by themselves. But the multitude saw them departing and many knew him and ran there on foot from all the cities. They arrived before them and came together to him. And Jesus, when he came out, saw a great multitude and was moved with compassion for them because they were like sheep not having a shepherd. So he began to teach them many things. The context of this passage, Jesus and the disciples were having a very busy time. And the disciples had gone and done a lot of things to make a difference in the lives of people, and they came and reported to Jesus. And they were all tired, so Jesus told the disciples, come along with me, let's go to a deserted place, a quiet place, and let's get some rest. So this is one of those times when they wanted to get away from people. Have you been in a place like that? Probably some of you are in a place like that. You don't want to take another phone call. You don't want to meet another person. You're kind of drained out, you're physically, emotionally drained. You know, sometimes even in ministry, we can get to a place like that. We've given out. And Jesus and the disciples were in a place like that. They wanted to just go somewhere. They wanted to rest. They wanted to eat. They wanted to just be with themselves. They don't want to meet. They did not want to meet anybody else. So they got on a boat and they traveled. And when they got to the other side, a great multitude of people, they had known where Jesus and the disciples were going and they ran on foot. And they got there. So now if you were in the place of Jesus, what would you be thinking? I know what I would be thinking. I'd be like, oh my God, I don't have energy to do another talk. I don't have energy for some more ministry. You know, I just need to rest, I need to sleep. And we would pick up scriptures to substantiate that, you know, God rested on the seventh day, you know, this is my time to rest, which is all right, which is correct. You need to rest. But what Jesus did really amazes me, and why he was able to do that and where he got the energy from is what I want to talk to you about today. You know, Jesus, he saw the multitudes. He saw them that they were like sheep without a shepherd. You know, your perspective brings you energy. When you see a need, when you see a person, when you see a situation, the perspective in which you see that person or that situation can either cause you to walk away or cause you to move forward. If you see people as a problem, if you see people as a pain, if you see people as people who would drain your energy out, or if you see people based on their background, if you see people based on the labels that they come with, you know, you might have excuses to make to walk away. But Jesus looked at these people. They were young and old. They were probably educated, not, you know, uneducated, a mix of all different kinds of people. They came from different towns. They probably spoke with different accents, from different demography. But he saw them all in one category. He saw them as sheep without a shepherd. Sheep without a shepherd are lost. Sheep without a shepherd are hurting. Sheep without a shepherd are bleeding. Sheep without a shepherd are thirsty, hungry. You know, they're tired, worn out. He did not see them on the basis of any other labels. He saw them all as people who were lost, people who were hungry, people who really needed and deserved help at that point. Sheep without a shepherd cannot find its way without the intervention of a good shepherd. How do you see people? When you go to work, maybe you've had a long journey to work. You know, maybe you've commuted 2 or 3 trains. Maybe you had a difficult morning at home, but when you get to work, how do you see people around you? How do you see people who are in your team? How do you see them? Maybe there are people around you who need your help, who need your intervention. There are people around you who are emotionally drained out, who are spiritually hungry, who are hurting on the inside. My dear friend, today, as I conclude, I want to encourage you to see people the way Jesus saw the people. Even if you are tired, even if you yourself are in a place where you are emotionally, physically drained out, the Apostle Paul says, though outwardly we are wasting away, inwardly we are being renewed. We are being strengthened day by day. There is a strength that comes from your inside. There is a river that can flow from the inside of you, no matter what your external condition is. Today I pray that you will be a person from whom that rivers of living water will flow to people around you. You will be a person who would bring healing to people around you. You will be a person who would be a source of blessing to people in your world. That is my prayer for you today.
Thank you so much, friends, for watching this with us. This was Pastor Biju Thampi, and I'm sure you are highly encouraged and you are now full of enthusiasm, and you have to make sure whatever is your situations cannot rule you, but Jesus has to rule you. So go and inspire others. Please like, subscribe and share our channel, and if you have any prayer requests, please do send it to us. If you want to be part of our channel, do connect with us. May God bless you. Stay tuned to The Other 167.